Hello everybody, thanks for joining us today. My name is Clementine and I will be your host. Please note that we cannot hear you as you are all on mute. If you have any questions during the presentation, please use the chat window below and we will address any questions during an open Q&A session at the end of the presentation. So let's begin with today's speakers, Jeff and Olivier. Jeff, would you like to start?
Yep. Hello. So hello everybody. My name is Jean-François Pio. Working at JSX since 2008. I'm a product manager at the company, and I will be very happy to present you all the opportunities of business that you can have with JSX, especially today on the Office 65 management and Office 65 services. And I am with Olivier right now.
Yeah, hi. So indeed, my name is Olivier. I'm a Microsoft specialist and a technical sales manager at GSX. I've been with GSX since 2009, and I'll be happy to present you some demos today of the product based on what Jeff will mention and explain to you on how you can benefit from those tools. And I'll be happy to answer as well any technical questions that you might have during the presentation at the end.
Thank you, Olivier. So let's start with a quick agenda. So we will explain you really quickly who we are, who is GSX. Maybe some of you already know us, some not, so I will spend 1 minute doing that. Speaking a bit about the Microsoft strategy, like what happened with the Office 65, with the margin, with how they are working with partner, and what is the goal of Microsoft. So that will be the first part. Then we will see how you can fit in this strategy and how, thanks to JSX, you can really deliver service that will help Microsoft in their strategy and will help you building profitable business around Office 65. I will give you a real business plan example at the end, and then after that we will have a Q&A session. So let's start really quickly with the, who is JSX. We are a software company providing tools for a large enterprise and MSP since 1996. So it's about 20 years now that we are in the business and that we are providing monitoring, reporting tool, management tool for different environment, but mostly focused on unified communication. So we have multiple offices in the world in order to support all of our partners and customers. As you can see in USA where we are today, Boston and Buffalo, headquarters in Geneva, and different offices with development, sales, and support in Europe and in APAC. So maybe we can go quickly to some customer references. You can see here large customer that we have, also large MSP that we are working with. We are working with these large customers, again, a bit everywhere in the world, EMEA, APAC, and of course in USA. So now that we have quickly seen where JSX solution come from, let's take some minutes to identify where Microsoft is going and how it has impacted the traditional business of its reseller. So you have to see that even if Microsoft is doing a great job at converting its customer to Office 65, its journey to the cloud isn't finished. It's just starting. Because Microsoft is competing directly with AWS and other providers like Google, SoftLayer, this kind of provider, for the main cloud market, that is the IaaS and the PaaS, infrastructure as a service or platform as a service. These competitors are very dangerous for Microsoft because they could potentially start to provide services that would compete directly with the core Microsoft business, Office and Windows. And we have already seen the rise of Chrome OS, for example, and we've seen as well AWS proposing image services connected to an OutCloud client. So regarding Office 65, Microsoft has to make sure that its customers are moving to the cloud and using it. Then they have to push their Azure services inside their client's infrastructure. So what are the consequences for the software reselling business? At first, reseller margin were okay. And then, of course, as you may know, they dropped. On top of that, large customers are mostly managed with an enterprise agreement that makes the resale of licenses more difficult for most partners. Additionally, maybe you know that migration services that were generally a good way to have a profitable business are now often competing directly with Microsoft that provide this kind of migration services for free in some cases. So what does Microsoft want from their partner? Clearly, the interest of Microsoft is to make sure that customers are using regularly their cloud licenses. So they push partners in order to deliver support and high value added services to their customers. That's the sense of the CSP program. By doing that, they are making sure that the customers are slowly transitioning to Microsoft cloud services in order to position their Azure service later. So for you, partner, it's clearly the time to develop additional value services around Office 365 in order to go side by side with the Microsoft strategy. If you do that with the CSP program, for example, it will provide you up to 28% margin on an Office 365 seat, plus all the margin you will make with these new services. For Microsoft, it will be a sign that you are fitting in their strategy and that you are preparing the field for the next battle, that is the Azure battle. So let's see now how you can fit in Microsoft strategy. You know, there are three traditional ways generally to build software. To build services around this software. You can sell customer support. So a lot of partners are selling like custom support for Office 365. You can sell as well, you can have package with intellectual property, meaning you can package other software into the Office 365 offering. Or you can provide any other form of services attached to Office 365 like migration, management, monitoring, etc. But each time you have to assess the real value for the customer, the long-term value for you, and of course the profitability. And we will see today how this kind of service can be profitable. What's good with this general migration to Office 365 is that more and more large companies are taking that direction. It means that more and more of these large companies need services, and it opens a large new market. For example, full administration service can lower the admin costs of the customer. Reporting services can easily be provided to deliver financial reports and ROI. And finally, you can use services like end-to-end monitoring to put a foot in the door in your customer infrastructure. So now let's see how to deliver the value to your customer. At GSX, we develop tools that are making the partner life easier. Our tools have been first developed for IT teams that are providing services for multiple business lines. So these tools have been used in very large enterprises that have to deliver services for subsidiary, business line, other companies sometimes. And these tools have also proved to be a perfect way for different size of MSP to provide additional services around Office 365, increasing their margin and their footprint at their customer. With our tool, user and license administration, end-to-end performance monitoring, and advanced usage reporting service can be easily provided and transformed into a really profitable business. So what's the GSX 365 squad? GSX 365 Squad provides these three different services. As we just said, user license administration, end-to-end user performance, advanced usage reporting. So we will see through the demo all what you can do with the tool and how you can implement that to make a profitable business around Office 365 reselling. So now we have to, this slide will tell you a bit what is the value for the customer. So as we have developed tool to make that partner life easier, now you can see what is the value for your end user. First, having you managing their licenses and their exchange user will considerably reduce their administration costs. Secondly, getting advanced usage reporting on Office 365 will allow your customer to anticipate their costs and calculate their ROI. Finally, having you taking care of the overall availability and performance of the service is a guarantee that resources are optimized, that end users are satisfied, and that critical businesses process will not suffer latency or downtime. At the same time, the value for you is, of course, the margin that you will get with this service. But it's also a way for you to be seen as a trusted advisor on the cloud service market. And that's exactly what Microsoft wants you to be in order to be ready for the Microsoft Azure battle. So at the end, it's a win-win situation for everybody. So let's go a bit deeper now in each of the different services that you can provide with our tool. And each time, we will follow that with a little demo of the tool itself. So here, we will speak about how to reduce your customer administration costs. The first service that JSX tool enable is the Exchange Online User Management. Exchange Online requires PowerShell expertise to be managed. User requests can be sometimes done through the Office 365 portal, but most of the time, they need PowerShell skills. For your customer, it involves costly resources that spend their time performing basic end-user requests, like creating and managing distribution groups, resetting passwords, forwarding mailbox, etc. They cannot have any economy of scale with their resources. JSX 365 Enterprise Management is the JSX solution to drastically reduce the management costs of Exchange Online. With that tool, you can manage directly the Exchange Online user of your customer for a fraction of their costs, and we will see that just after. There is no PowerShell skill required. You can have non-Office 365 experts managing Exchange Online, performing tasks like end-user password distribution groups, onboarding user, etc. And everything is audited. It means that if one of your resources made a mistake, you can easily know who, where, and when in order to fix it. And that is something you will never be able to do with the Office 365 portal. And for your customer, it is keeping the same logic of cost reduction. So now that the infrastructure have moved to Office 365, the next step for them is to, of course, reduce also the cost on the administration. And in the business plan after, you will see that it's very, the cost of administration of each Office 365 seat is really high. And that's really a way that is easy for you to compete and to provide really profitable business while reducing drastically the cost at your customer site. So now, Oliver will show you a quick demo and see you how you can use that to make business.
Yeah, thank you, Jeff. So let me go to the tool and show you a quick demo. So it's also a tool that you can easily use because it's completely cloud-based. Once you have access to the portal, you can log in. So here I'm logged in with a full administrator, so some kind of super admin. So this tool, as you will see, is really designed for MSPs. First, like, it's multi-tenant, so if you have multiple clients, tenants that you want to see, you can quickly display them or search through them. So it's totally multi-tenant. And so as Jeff said, there's no PowerShell skill required. Like, anybody can have access to this portal, and you can have different users with different sets of permissions that would be accessing this tool. So with this tool, you don't need to go through the Office 365 portal or to have any kind of scripts or anything. We use some APIs from Microsoft and some PowerShell commandlets as well. So the first step that you can see here is like a global recap of your different licenses, all the different users. But the main tab would probably be here, the Users tab. So here you can easily delegate that access to this tab and to like all the viewing and editing possibilities that the tool has to offer. You can easily access the information on any user. So if you're also doing support for your client, for example, some users complain and call in, you can immediately identify what's that customer, all the information from the Active Directory, which distribution groups, license, mailbox usage. And one of the great powerful features is all the permissions. So directly from here, you can assign, edit, or remove new calendar permission or a delegation to have sent on behalf, full access to the mailbox. So anybody can do that without needing any kind of scripts to do this. Of course, you can reset password, change any of those values. So really easy. And any of those changes, and also you can do anything with the distribution groups, which has been something often asked to easily manage membership and add, remove people from distribution groups. One thing that's really good as well, as Jeff mentioned, is that you can track any changes that are performed. So if you have different users, different technicians, admins accessing different environments and making some changes, you can keep track up to a year to the different changes that have been made. You can easily double click, search for specific users if they've done some specific changes onto some environments. So really easy, and you can have more information as well if you double click on any of those transactions, understand who did what, when. So here I added some user in the distribution groups. So one of the things I wanted to show you real quick too is all the user administration. So you can have as many admins or technicians accessing the tool for your different customers, and you can provide them with different access and level of permissions as you might need. So if you have multiple clients, you might select different tenants here, select what permissions they can use, and you can even refine that even more for specific users if some admins should only be able to manage users that are located in America. You can create a specific organizational units. Last thing I'll show you, there's a lot in the tool, but I want to focus on the key features here, is you can automate a lot of those actions by using the organizational units. Basically, you can have some specific rules that would be applied automatically. So such things like license assignments, distribution groups, permissions, those are things, especially for licenses, that usually companies or partners have scripts for. So here you can just automate that through through the tool. So it really helps to divide your administration costs and allow you to manage your clients and tenants through that tool in a centralized way as well. I'll turn back to the presentation and to Jeff for the webinar.
Yeah, thank you, Olivia. So let's go to the next slide now. The second tool GSX Solution is offering is a pure SaaS reporting tool for Office 365 usage. One of the challenges that companies moving to the cloud are now facing is to know what they are consuming and what is their ROI. They want to pay just for what they use and not more. But before, they had some way to extract statistics from Exchange. But now it is very complex to know what they are really using, who is using what, and how they could improve their ROI. GSX 365 usage is made to face all these challenges. It gathers all the possible statistics from the Office 365 portal, from many PowerShell commands, from the Exchange admin console, from Active Directory, in order to make them available for easy reporting without any PowerShell skills. It allows non-IT people to access in a secure way all this data and provide reports. With GSX 365 usage, you can easily provide all these reports your customer needs in an automatic and cost-efficient way. Statistics are automatically gathered and centralized in the portal. Then you just have to schedule the reports and send them to your customer. After this initial configuration, you just have to let it run. Your customer will receive automatically the report and statistics they need to control their budget and costs, for example, measure the end user adoption and productivity, optimize their network performance, control their migration project, enhance their mobile security, or even manage their identity access management. None of these reports can be created with the Office 365 portal. This is why providing them will produce a lot of value to your customer. So, Oliver, let's see again quickly how partners can use that tool in order to provide a very profitable and value business.
Sure. So, again, I mean, that tool is cloud-based, so you can easily access that, and I encourage you to sign up and try this on your own tenant or a test tenant. It's really easy. It takes about 5 minutes to sign up. And then we'll build that that portal for you. So let's check a little bit the tool. So as Jeff mentioned, so it's completely cloud-based. There's nothing that you need the specific skills in PowerShell or any APIs. Again, you have this dashboard for each of the tenants that you would like to sign up. So you can sign up a specific customer. Here we're looking at one of our tenants. First thing is you have different dashboards that you can build if you want to keep track of specific items for each of your clients. But the main thing is really all the data that we collect and that we present you in really nice format and display that you can send automatically to your clients. So some of the reports I really liked is all the inactive users by service. So it really helps your clients to understand what they're actually using from each of the platforms. So of course, everybody is using email, but are people really using OneDrive and Skype? So this is a good recap, high level, that kind of summarizes that information. And if you'd like, you can easily schedule automatically that report to be sent to your clients as a nice PDF, and you could say, okay, I want to send that every couple of months to my client directly, so you have nothing to do. The report is sent automatically, and they benefit from some more insights about what they're actually using within Office 365. We have different use cases that are really interesting, such as some training or identifying better who is using what for the licenses, and maybe do some cross-charging throughout the different departments, or identify in specific locations who is using specific platforms better than others. One of the key things of our reports is really the customization and the filtering. So those filters are not possible in the Office 365 portal. So if you want to identify specific departments, you can see here I have all the fields coming from Azure Active Directory, which means if you're synchronizing your identities with an on-premise AD, you would see all those information here as well. So for example, department, I can say, okay, department equal sales, and I want to understand maybe that department, how they're using the service, so I can see they're using a much much better use of OneDrive than the rest. So this is high level, but then you can really deep dive inside of those tools. So for example, email, it's great to understand mail traffic overall, but a lot of our clients or partners, they wanted to identify internal versus external email. So one of the use cases, for example, is sometimes you see a lot of internal emails, and some companies have found that's not very productive. So a great way is to implement the use of Skype for Business for instant messaging better in the company, so that people are not sending like 200 emails a day anymore, and they can focus more on the work and communicate more instantly using Skype for Business. So a great report was to keep track of that evolution and compare that with the use of Skype for Business online and make sure that users are actually using that service. So there are a lot of different reports, of course, on traffic, the distribution groups, identifying how to optimize the environment. And you can send those reports directly to your clients, or you can even package this into some services so that you could provide even more value to your customer and perform those services yourself. So a lot of great features in this tool, including the retention, that we keep track of the information forever, so you can do some really long-term reports and capacity planning, or planning overall. And as Jeff mentioned, we have this for the tenant overall, the mail traffic, Exchange, Skype for Business, a lot of reports on the mobility, security, a lot of reports on SharePoint. Many of our partners like this different security reports, identifying what permissions are assigned, who has access to what. A lot of around also what we call IAM to make sure about the identity and access management. So some great feature here. I really recommend you contacting us or trying to sign up for this tool to try it for yourself.
Okay, so thank you, Oliver. So let's see now the third kind of services, third tool that we provide. First tool is JSX Monitor. Basically, it's the best solution in the market to monitor the service delivered by Office 65. You may already provide support for Office 65, but you have no way to detect and troubleshoot any problem outside of a configuration issue of Office 65. As soon as the collaboration service becomes critical for a company, monitoring the service delivered to critical users and locations become a must-have. I can tell you that because that's how we sell our monitoring solution to large companies. When companies have 50 users and are in a full cloud environment, they might not be really sensitive to the level of services that they provide to their end user. But as soon as the infrastructure becomes more complex, including email security software appliance, hybrid identity management like Azure AD Connect or DFS, load balancer, management device solution, or hybrid exchange, monitoring is becoming really critical. There too many pieces of infrastructure that are interconnected and that can lead to performance and availability issues. Providing a real support to your customer is being able to help them optimizing their infrastructure. It's being able to provide the same quality of service to their critical location and to anticipate potential network or capacity issues. And it's also something you want to do in order to introduce your company as an infrastructure expert, because that will enable you to advise them for future cloud investments like Microsoft Azure, for example. The monitoring of the infrastructure is a key to go from a pure Office 365 service provider to a larger cloud infrastructure service advisor. JSX Monitor has been designed specifically for that, allowing you to monitor the end user experience of Office 365 as well as the health and performance of everything that might impact that service. So it is your key to enter in the infrastructure business. So again, Oliver, thank you again. Can you show that quickly?
Sure. Thank you.
Thank you.
So some of you might be familiar with GSX Monitor. So I'll focus a little bit more today on the monitoring for Office 365, but we do monitor a lot of different platforms around unified communication. So first thing that your clients might be interested in is monitoring their actual tenants in Office 365, because after they experience the first kind of issues, latency, or even some unavailability of that service, they start to look at how they can be alerted, how can they know when Office 365 is actually providing service to them or not. So a great way to monitor is we have those different scenarios that you can configure directly to point to a specific tenant and do things like opening just a mailbox on Office 365. So you can do that very easily, just need a set of credentials and we'll connect to your tenant, making sure that end users in the client's company are able to access the service and their tenant. But we don't stop there. We have multiple actions that you can configure to actually interact with the mailbox, such as creating new items, delete the attachments, search, resolve other users in the address list, so anything that end users can do in their Outlook clients. So we do this for Outlook, but also for ActiveSync to make sure that all the mobile devices are able to connect to the ActiveSync service in their Office 365 tenants. So this is one of the first features that you can configure along with the mail routing to test that emails are able to route the different paths. This is also a great tool to use if your clients are using any on-prem or cloud-based infrastructure for gateways or anti-spam, security, and encryption like Iron Port, devices like that. So this is a great first step to actually monitor the tenant, but 90% of the Office 365 deployments that are out there, and probably most of your clients' ones, are probably still having a lot of components on-premise. So as Jeff mentioned, things like ADFS, Azure AD Connect, because most clients still have identities on-premise using Active Directory. So those are key components that you need to monitor as well, because they might impact the different end users that are accessing the service from multiple locations. So as you can see here, we have multiple platforms. I'm just going to focus on the one today that are actually impacting Office 365. So you can see Azure AD Connect here. We're able to monitor the specific server running that synchronization. We have specific checks that are performed to ensure that synchronization is successful, and that will let you know if there are any errors in that synchronization, if it didn't run, and if there are issues, we'll tell you what user, what objects are not able to synchronize, so that you can take action immediately, or you can notify your clients directly from this tool. So same thing for ADFS, Azure for Active Directory that's on-premise. We also have different network checks that we perform, because in the different locations, you can deploy GSX Monitor, configure the scenarios as we've seen, and maybe you have your clients have some end users located in APAC that when they access the tenant in Europe or in USA, they have more latency. So you need to identify that latency and understand how it's actually why it's impacted and what is impacting the latency. So great features here would be like the different trace route, testing the different ports connectivity, making some DNS resolution. That's very often a big cause of increased latency. And of course, we'll also check the health provided directly by Microsoft to see if they are doing any maintenance or any specific work. So by configuring this tool, you provide more visibility to our clients. This helps you to identify better the environment. And because there are still a lot of infrastructure on-premise, through everything about, around the identity, the anti-spam, you are able to set a first foot in the infrastructure of your clients and show that you have some expertise, and it's a great way to be compliant with the Microsoft strategy and have a good foot in between the on-premise infrastructure and the Azure infrastructure that they might be starting to build.
Okay, so thank you again, Olivier. So now let's speak a bit more about business plan. So let's come back on the slide. So the size of your customers may impact your ability to sell them different type of service offering. For example, customer with less than 100, 200 users might not really care about monitoring for different reasons. Sometimes their infrastructure is too simple, sometimes the collaboration tools aren't that critical for their business. So they might also have very little need of Exchange Online management because their population is very small. Of course, some small companies with highly critical collaboration tools exist as well. For example, law firms are extremely dependent on SharePoint. That's a case that we have a lot of time at JSX. But statistically, it is easier to sell reporting services to small companies. ROI, end user adoption and productivity, security report, mobile device usage and management, all these statistics can still be critical to them. And it is something really easy to provide thanks to JSX 365 usage. When a company is bigger, with more complex infrastructure and more users to manage, it becomes easier to sell the full package of services. When you have more than 500 users to manage, you start to need a full-time equivalent to handle onboarding, end user requests, issues, etc. Administration costs start to raise, and there are no possible economy of scale for them. For the partner, it is easy to provide administration costs that are way lower than what the customer are experiencing. Secondly, reporting is, of course, important for them too. So ROI, end user adoption, security, all these reports we've seen before are even more important for them. And finally, as the infrastructure is more complex, the need for monitoring increases. Hybrid infrastructure, multiple locations, critical collaboration applications need to be monitored in order to prevent issues that can lead to business line productivity loss. So the all-in-one package service allows you to face all their challenges at a very competitive price. So let's see a real-life example. Here is one of our partner real-life examples. This partner provides managed services to Office 365 customers. They are specialized in mid-sized enterprises that have between 1,000 to 5,000 users. They migrate a lot of them to Microsoft Office 365, and they wanted to keep a recurring revenue after the migration services. So they worked with us on a service plan that is based on our solutions. Now that they are managing around 10 customers with an average of 1,500 users per client, here is how they built a very profitable business while saving a lot of money for their customers. As we said, a mid-sized customer has fixed management costs without any possibility of economy of scale. They pay their licenses around $10 per month with the best plan they can have depending on their negotiation with Microsoft. Then they need at least one full-time equivalent for that is Office 365 expert or PowerShell expert, and that will cost them at least $100,000 per year. They will also need a network admin and some tools to have a sense of what's going on. And for that, they need to add another $100,000 per year. So when you divide all these additional costs per the number of seats, in this case 1,500, you understand that a $10 seat costs the customer around an $11 to manage. On the other side, a partner, CSME member, or that have special agreement with Microsoft, will buy the Office 365 license cheaper, of course. The partner can have two Office 365 and PowerShell experts being able to support everything about level 2 and level 3 for at least 10 customers, thanks to our tool. He can also hire low-cost administrator to handle every low management task, especially on Exchange Online, if they are using JSX 365 Enterprise Management, as Olivier showed you before. And finally, they just have to add the cost of the JSX package, that is 70 cents per user per month. So when you divide by the number of users that they manage, you realize that the difference of cost between what a customer pays and what a partner would pay to do the same job is around $10 per seat and per month, and that is your maximum margin. It means that even if you don't hit that maximum margin for different reasons, and there's always reason, and you only manage to have half of that margin, you still propose to your customer a way better service than they would ever have alone for half the cost. And that service includes the exchange user administration, the reporting, the ROI, the security report, and user adoption statistics, and the full end-to-end monitoring of the Office 365 services. Your customer cannot compete with that with their internal resources and costs. So you will be always cheaper than they can be because you have economy of scale that they cannot have. So to sum up what we've seen, GSX 365 Squad allow you to do a lot of different things. It allows you to fit into Microsoft strategy, make sure that your customers are using Office 365 license and put a foot in the door on the Azure business, to provide services that save your client money while being highly profitable for you, and to be qualified for CSP program if you're not already. And as we said in the beginning, it allows you to be seen as a trusted cloud advisor and position yourself for Microsoft Azure business. So if you want to work with us, you should know that we help our partners to set up trials and to onboard their clients. Our team is always here to help you doing business. And Olivier will be very happy to help you configuring the tool and to help you using it to deliver this kind of services. So feel free to contact us in order to schedule a free trial, and we will walk you through all the tools, train you on them, and on how to use them to provide services to your customer. So thank you for your attention, and I think it's time now to answer questions if you have any. Otherwise, thank you again.
Thank you, Jeff. We are just about to go over time for today's webinar, but if you have any questions, do not hesitate to send us an email, and we will get back to you in a few hours. I wanted to thank you all for attending today's webinar. Note that an evaluation is about to show up in your browsers. It would be very much appreciated if you could take a few seconds to provide us with your feedback. Anyway, thanks again, and have a great day.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.